Okay, so what I'm doing right here is I'm cutting down the pieces of eighth inch strapping. I bought them at an inch and a half wide, but to fit inside the 1 1/4 inch pipe, I need to cut them down to 1 5/16. And so I've got three of them ganged up together here, and I'm just using the porta band, and you can see how the waste, I've got, you know, since I'm just trimming off a little bit, you can see that the waste is able to pass freely around the edge of the porta band. So I can make most of the cuts this way, and then I will have to turn it around and cut on the other side. But I'm able to do about 10 inches or a foot on each cut. That's how I'm cutting this down. So I think after I get this done, you know, I'm putting some little clamps on here, then I'll just be able to put it up here and just float it with the grinder real quick and kind of straighten it out before I turn it into my spirals. Okay, I'm making the spirals that go inside the 1 1/4 inch pipe columns. And now here in the US, this is schedule 40 1 1/4 inch pipe, and that gives the inside dimension, you know, that's related on the inside dimension. But it is not 1 1/4 inches. It's actually quite a bit bigger. You know, because of the age we live in, I can keep all these things that I used to have diagrams for on my phone. So a 1 1/4 inch schedule 40 pipe, the ID is 1.38 inches. And so what I did is I went ahead and, so here's my first piece. We're gonna bend another piece like this. This is a 6-twist bend is what I did, or spiral. And you wanna use this as the retainer. So as you're bending it, it will wanna stop it from twisting and just turning into a knot. So when I cut these pieces, I cut them at 1 5/16. And then I tested every one of them before I did this, because I wanted to make sure, could I stick it in here and could I spin it 360 degrees without it binding and interfering with the weld bead. It will get slightly smaller when I twist it, and but that's what I'm getting ready to do. And when I cut these 10 inches longer than the length of this pipe, so I'm going to have 5 inches sticking out at each end. And the overall reduction in length, let me hold that equal here, this is how much it shortened it, about 1 3/8 of an inch on 6 twists. So it changes some things, but not a whole lot. So what I'm going to do here is I've got this piece of pipe securely held in these two vices. And I'm going to stick it in here, and I'm going to make sure that I'm sticking out 5 inches on each end. And you may ask, why don't you heat this up to make the bending easier? And you don't want to attempt that, because you're not going to be able to give something of this length and this size an even heat. And so if the heat is not perfectly even, it's going to twist different in different places where it was heated more. So you want to cold bend this. But I mean, you can see how really perfect this is. I mean, this was eighth inch. These were the practice pieces I did too much. That's too much spiral. I wanted it to be a little bit more straight down to not impede the airflow as it was going down. And this was also a little bit thinner material. Westbrook only had eighth inch material, so this is eighth inch, so it's, you know, it's a little stout. So the first thing I want to do is make sure that I've got 5 inches sticking out at this end. Five inches. And I'm going to put this Model 72 Jorgensen clamp on here. And I'm going to make sure it's good and tight. And square. Okay. Now I'm going to put this other Jorgensen on here, but I'm going to leave myself a quarter of an inch of space at the end. So I'm going to do 4 or 5 turns, and then and it's going to pull it up, and then I'll have to release it just a little bit more. But I want to make sure this is good and square, and I'm just eyeballing a quarter of an inch. Okay, so I'm going to count as the clamp comes down on this side. I'm going to count. Let me make sure I got this in a good frame here. So I'm going to count as I spin this and make sure that I don't mess up, that I get 6 turns. And like I said, I'm going to release this after about 4. Because it will pull this as the thing shrinks down because of the spiral. It's gonna bind on this, so I need to release it. So I'll go. One. There's one. Two. Three. I think I can go one more and then I'll adjust it. Three. There's four. Five. Six. And this kind of deforms this up a little bit, so I'm going to use this to bend it down and straighten it out a little bit. And these tabs will get cut off too, a little bit of the length. I got to still decide what I'm going to do with that. Okay, that looks good. And let me bring it back a little bit too. Perfect. there's a six twist bend right there. These two should be very, very close to one another. Okay, so I have another one to do. It's a little bit longer, and I think I'm going to do six twists on it also. And I think if it just stretches it out just a little bit, it'll be okay. So there's two that are this size, and then one that's a little bit longer on that first column. Okay, something really interesting that happens. I just took this piece of pipe and put it back in my shop where I've got my all my setup going, and I put the pipe down on the ground, and all this black metallic, I know it was metal, you know, off this surface, came out of the pipe, because as you bend the pipe, this the surface of this is it's popping off and releasing that outer layer of scale. And I found it really pretty fascinating. You know, this has been outside a couple weeks ago. I did these practice twists a couple weeks ago and haven't had a chance to get back to this. But this is what this looked like here. This piece of strapping was this rusted. And just by twisting it, it popped off all that rust and left this surface here. So it's actually quite an interesting phenomena, you know, with the steel properties. So I've got this one piece that's a little bit longer, got it in here at 5 inches sticking out each end. And it's only 3 inches longer, so I'm gonna still do a six twist bend on it. Well, I can't find the mark on the piece because look at this bizarre phenomena here. So as the thing got twisted, the action of it, actually, I did not do anything to this. This is the way it started off before it was spiraled. It looked just like this, rusted and oxidized, but something happened to it mechanically while it was being twisted where it just flung off all that rust. But this is so exciting for me to figure this out.